So my daily challenge today includes the Crossroads 50 coins and defeat the squirrel crate. And that's one of the bosses of Crossroads. I wanted to show how I do Crossroads.
Shall we begin at the beginning? Demure rolling hills.
So the first thing is I want to pick rivers, and it's not one of my options. So I press X to shuffle my choices until I get rivers as one of the options. Set the water height all the way to the maximum, the land height all the way to the minimum, and I change the river width all the way to the maximum, though river width is not really that important.
Choose rivers. Ah, Spock, what a picture you paint.
You can choose any of these three. I prefer to do Arctic. Keep the water height the same. Nature density, I turn to zero. Peak material height, I'll make that the maximum. Shore material height, also at the maximum.
Watch they don't melt at your touch. What time is it at the setting of the sun?
Now, I prefer day with the sun angle at the minimum, just because that's full brightness and everything's easy to see.
Ah, Spark, what a world you've created.
So because I set the water height to the maximum and the land height to the minimum, we get a very sparse world that's mostly water covered.
What is it that your hero must do now? This land is your land. Ah, the heart of the village.
I always choose the village well because it's very small.
All's well that ends well, I say. Ah, Spark, you're my hero.
And I play with the goblin. He's just a very...
The unexpected,
I don't know.
I say,
he's easy to play, so I like him.
Quest awaits your heroes.
So jump over that and talk to this guy.
Keep your enemies close, but maybe not.
So I don't have
close.
The zombies yet. I'll be getting that later this week. If I choose the bandits, they can shoot at me, so that's a little more dangerous. So I always choose goblins.
Goblins gobbling up. The battle begins here.
So kill those three goblins.
A hero is a hero.
And then I just let him choose the reward. I'm not going to be getting the reward today, so it doesn't matter. Magic apple he chose.
Where does your hero travel? A grand castle of stone?
Now, I like to choose the fortress.
A fortified fortress?
Because the battle area keeps the enemies from falling off the island or moving around too much. It's all sort of locked into the little area there.
Where in the world will you be?
I move it all the way to the back.
Now,
that creates a little bit more land and then maximizes this sort of walkway up to it.
Or would you prefer I do it for you?
I'm not doing any of the side quests, so I can avoid the two islands that were created with question marks. I go toward my main island, but not where the X is. I go just to the left of it. When it hits the land, I immediately turn back, line up as carefully as I can on this bridge. When I hit the land again, I immediately turn back and do the same thing a third time, lining up as carefully as you can. And when you overlap bridges like this, it builds them on top of each other, and so you end up with a triple bridge. So then we just want to go over to the X.
All that begins ends, often badly, of course.
You end up with a triple thick bridge that, as soon as I get over there, you can see. So we have a straight path right to the end, and everywhere there was a coin on the bridge, there are now three coins. So I'm going for 50 coins here. Now, if I had a side quest, I would do this same process, only there would be an island in the middle. I would go to one of the two islands, do a side quest, and then do this. Usually what ends up happening when I have a side quest is I do the coins first, and then I restart Crossroads and do just the side quest. You don't have to do them all at once. So that bridge gave me 48 coins. So I ignore anything else that may have spawned and go straight for the end. Now I know that I'm going to be defeating the squirrels at the end, and they're going to give me plenty of coins to get me over 50. So I can just fight one guard.
Hopefully they hold up.
if your bridge wasn't quite long enough, like if you had done one of the side quests, you end up with fewer coins on your bridges. You can fight more guards here to beef it up. And I've never counted how many you get from the spoil crate, but I would guess it's probably 8 to 10. So I need one more for my 50.
Nothing stands between the hero and triumph.
So I'm going to fight this crate of rapid squirrels.
Cute nibbles? You know when they say there'll be a test? Here it is.
These are very easily damaged with your berserker attack. So as soon as you can get that, you just spin around, and then very quickly they're all dead. So at this point, I've got the Defeat the Squirrel Crate daily achievement, or challenge. I could leave right now. So I had 49 coming into this battle, and I have 55 now, so it looks like I only got 6. So, the challenges are done. So I've got my Defeat the Squirrel Crate and daily Crossroads, and you can check the time on this video to see how long that took. So that's how I play Crossroads.